Hello, this is Yukio Watanabe at Mechanical Simulation Corporation. I would like to introduce the latest features of CarSim and TruckSim Electrified Powertrain model. Here are the contents. Firstly, I would like to present overview of the hybrid electric powertrain model. Next, the latest version 2021 electrified powertrain model is presented. Then, the recent progress in VehicleSim powertrain model is explained. Since we have introduced the hybrid model in 2018, we now support various types of electrified powertrain model as shown in this picture. Then, I would like to show briefly data settings and several simulation examples. The hybrid model is based on Prius hybrid concept, and the model was originally studied by the University of Michigan. The model consists of electric motor, battery, generator, planetary gear, and internal combustion engine. There are four power modes on hybrid: motor only, engine only, motor plus engine, and regenerative brake. The mode is automatically switched by power demand from the driver, which is namely the throttle position. The picture right-hand side shows a simple acceleration and braking maneuver.
In the beginning, the car accelerated with electric motor. Then it switched to engine mode to drive and charge the battery in the same time. For faster acceleration, both engine and motors are applied. When the car is coasting, it switched to engine mode to maintain the speed. Then, regenerative brake is applied to recharge the battery during the deceleration.
2021 model adds the ability to drive each wheel independently by an electric motor. For the case of motor-driven wheel, the motor can be located at in-wheel or sprung mass. All electric motors are involved in the battery state of charge calculation.
This slide summarizes progress of electrified powertrain past 3 years. The powertrain model used to support conventional powertrain only until 2018. In the middle of 2018, an external hybrid model in Simlink was produced. In 2019, the same hybrid model was built in internally via solver. Version 2019.1 introduce pure electric powertrain by enabling to switch on and off the hybrid components. Version 2020 enabled multiple electric motors, one on each axle, and version 2021 enables multiple electric motors, one on each wheel. So, let me demonstrate how to set the data. To specify the type of powertrain, select one of three options from the link control on the powertrain screens. Internal combustion engine is the traditional type of powertrain. Hybrid involves an engine, generator, motors, and batteries. With electric, the power source is only electric motors, and the engine link is disabled from the screens. The two links below are replaced with a hybrid electric assembly and power management controls. With hybrid options, the same engine model is used. This screen assembles hybrid electric devices, electric motor, generator, planetary gear set, and battery, with charging resistance and discharging resistance, open circuit voltage, and battery capacity in tables. If you specify pure electric, check this box to hide the hybrid devices. Check this box to specify multiple motors on each of differential axles. Next screen specifies the power management. There are three power modes on hybrid system: motor only, engine only, motor plus engines. The mode is automatically switched by power demand from driver, which is namely the throttle positions. Battery charge level is maintained between the target and lower boundary levels. The animation and plot on the left-hand side show a simulation result with EPA urban cycle maneuvers. As you can see, the battery level is maintained during the economy testing cycle. If you specify pure electric, check the box to hide the control parameters only used by hybrid. This is an extended capability to specify one or two electric motors on each drive axle. This feature is available from version 2021. If you select one motor, the motor locates on center of differentials. If you select two motors, the motors are directly connected with both side of wheels. Also, you can specify how the motor torques are reacted. For infill motor, check the box.
This is an extended example of the hybrid all-wheel drive using powertrain mount options. This mid-rear mount powertrain unit consists of an engine and electric motor driving the rear wheels, and two motors driving front wheels are independent from the unit. The powertrain unit is a separate mass specified on a separate screen.
On these screens, you can specify the mass and inertia of the powertrain unit, CG height, and CG location, number of mount bushes, and mount characteristics.
The animation shows the powertrain unit reacting from the drive torques, and two independent electric motors drive front wheels. You can observe how the powertrain unit reacts during the acceleration and deceleration maneuver with the hybrid powertrain system.
The same hybrid and electric powertrain models are also applicable for heavy trucks in TruckSim. This example shows 5-axle electric tractor with towing trailer. In this example tractor, all wheels are electrically driven with 10 motors.
This is all my presentation. Thank you so much for your kind attention.